I don't know, whatever it is. We'll record any which way it will record. So we said, we went through, tried a few times, that a Jew's mission is to have dominion over the Malachim. We said that Malachim, because they're so dedicated to Kodesh Baruch Hu and to perfection, cannot stand that the human being was flawed in sins or whatever it is, will have them shalom over them. It's unthinkable for them. So they push the person, the minute the person does something that is, you know, not according to the covenant of Kodesh Baruch Hu, he's being pushed away by the Malach. That's it. It's a horror for a person and everything. The way that a person can withstand that battle with the Malachim, which is all the Yitzhar that they have and everything, is by Shleimus Ayira. You know, it's that the heart is the way it's supposed to be, is the heart is called Yerushalayim, the Yira Shalom. That the Torah says, you know, what is a thing that is, what is a mission, a task that is given to the heart, that is assigned to the heart, is the Yira. You know, the Yira is in the heart, and when the Yira is Shalom, the Yira is proper, where it needs to be, then a person can tell who of the leaders of the generation are really true leaders and you should connect to them, and who are fake, you know, leaders that call themselves leaders because they want to. Why not? A lot to learn.
So these angels try to stray us off the course of our connection to the
to Kodesh Baruch Hu, not to the Kodesh Baruch Hu. And the way to withstand the battle against the kinna, the jealousy of the Malachim, is by connecting to the tzaddikim. Why? Because the tzaddikim represent the totality of Nishmas Yisrael, because they combine all Nishmas Yisrael under them. And that particular roots of Nishmas Yisrael, when you hold on to it, the Malachim cannot push you off. And we gave a whole story about Moshe Rabbeinu going to Shemayim. This is Malachim says, what is he doing here? He says, come to the Kabbal Torah. So, you know, they say, you know, this is preposterous. So, because Baruch Hu said, Moshe Rabbeinu, you know, answer them. He says, I'm afraid they're going to burn me up, you know, with the breath of their mouths. So, because Baruch Hu says, hold on to my seat of honor. That's the Shorish Nivish Yisrael. This is where, you know, that's the original womb that the souls of Israel emanate from. You hold on to that, the Malach, because in the Shoresh, in the root, a Jew is higher than the Malach. So every, you know, Jew separately, the Malach can push him off. Even Moshe Rabbeinu. It says Kiviyah. But when okay. So we said, sorry, what do you say?
How do we come to this battle with people?
When you don't feel like learning, you don't feel like davening, you feel like you're doing whatever, that's the battle.
Yetzirah is the
ensuing thing that ensues, the kinnas of Malachim, that awakens the Yetzirah in you. When the malachim are jealous, that causes the Yetzirah to wake up within you.
So we hear the Yetzirah, but
it's rooted in the jealousy of the malachim.
Okay. Wow. I thought the Yetzirah was just something you're born with.
Yes, you're born with it, you know, but if the malachim don't, you know, don't interfere, won't wake up, you know, it won't get up. The kin of the malachim is basically a demand. It's a heavenly demand. Mishamayim. Because the Kodesh Baruch Hu is eternal, infinite, and without end. And any kind of imperfection before HaKadosh Baruch Hu, as far as the malachim are concerned, is inexcusable. The minute that somebody who is imperfect, a human being, in other words, wants to get close to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the malachim are incensed. I mean, you are imperfect, and you want to be over us. You know, it's not that they, you know, that they are like selfish, and they hold on just one second. Hold on just one second. I got to speak to him, and this is not a...
Moshe.
Hello?
I don't want to see the video.
All right. Works, doesn't work, whatever. Anyhow, so we said that the thing that enables a person to tell who is a true leader, the Kedusha of Am Yisrael, and who is not, is when the heart, yearn, the heart is complete, is full, is perfect. Then a Yid can tell. A Yid can tell. And we said the entire Torah is concentrated on that particular ability to recognize the true manhigim and through them become impregnable to the jealousy of the malach.